So I started my career as a fashion designer and learned about that, but then I became a creative director. So I moved from London to New York, and then later became a creative director for Nike in Asia. So I built this sort of understanding of what's going on around the world. But when I got back from Hong Kong to New York, I wanted to do something more. So I worked at Parsons. I became the dean of the School of Fashion at Parsons. And that's when I really started to understand my philosophy of design. And I really developed the love of sharing that philosophy, sharing design thinking. So I did that for 7 years. At the end of that, I created Fashion Culture Design, Shoshang Wenhua Shijia. I did that because I wanted to bring together the brilliant people I'd met, all the brilliant people I know, and make sure that we continued those conversations, we continued that exploration of the thinking about design, whether it's architecture or fashion or media or communication or anything. Having created Fashion Culture Design, I then realized I need to share this knowledge. All the knowledge I've been creating, all the work I've done through my career as a designer, a design thinker, I wanted to share that, and so I created WeDesign. Now, WeDesign exists to bring the best professors around the world and match them with students that want to learn. Whatever they want to do in life, if they want to succeed as a lawyer or be a designer or an architect or whatever they want to do, we are here to help them to achieve that dream. And to me, that's a wonderful way of fulfilling my destiny. I am. And when I first came to Chengdu maybe 3 months ago, the first thing that struck me was the beautiful harmony between traditional buildings like the temple at Taikuli and the modern buildings that had been put around it, but very much in the spirit of what was there. It was this perfect blending of the old and the new. And you don't see that very much. I certainly don't see that around the world. And so that set me thinking that Chengdu was a really interesting place. There was something happening here that I don't see even in other parts of China. So I came back a few weeks after that, and now here I am back the third time. I'm excited especially to be here now because it's Fashion Week. So I'm finally going to get to see the fashion of Chengdu. I mean, I can walk the streets, I can see cool people, I can get a sense of the culture, the flavor of the people, but it's really this week that I'm excited about seeing Chengdu fashion. So if I'm honest, I haven't seen the best of Chengdu fashion yet. I'm here to see that, like a designer. And so I love to teach design to people that don't want to be designers, but they realize the value. You want to be a lawyer? You better be a good designer. You want to be a doctor? You better be a good designer. And so for me, my mission with WeDesign is to share design thinking with everybody, anyone that wants to learn, anyone that's smart and realizes that design is important can learn something. I learn things every day. Every single day I learn things, and I just want to share that passion and that openness and that success of thinking like a designer with everybody. Well, I'm delighted to be here. So my whole life has been in design. I was a designer and then a creative director, and then I was the dean of the design school, and now I have a fashion conference and a fashion education business. So everywhere I look, everything I do has been design, everything. And so I first came to Chengdu 3 months ago, and I think I kind of fell in love with it. You know, I went to Taikuli and I saw the way that a beautiful old temple had been incorporated into modern retail. And that doesn't happen anywhere else. And the same with Temple House, the hotel. So it set me thinking, what happens here in Chengdu that isn't happening elsewhere? And I wonder whether it's the ability of people here to work in harmony with the past. Like, I think it's interesting to look at the past, but we don't live in the past, we live in the future. And in order for this to be a successful fashion week, we've got to embrace the future. But I think if we can do that, inspired by the greatness of the past, then we have a great opportunity. As far as what Chengdu can do for the world of fashion, I think operating as a melting pot, bringing in all kinds of cultures, all kinds of designers, all kinds of brands and of visions, and welcoming them. Because the irony of the established fashion weeks is they're rather set in their ways. They're very good at what they do. And I live in New York, I'm very familiar with New York Fashion Week, and it's very good at what it does. But it's already doing something. You know, it's not got a clean slate. It has to continue the legacy that it has, the same with Paris and London and Milan. Whereas Chengdu, it's all bets are off. You can do anything here. And I think with the energy and the entrepreneurialism and the passion that Chinese people have, if we can open the doors to global fashion here, then I think we can do things here that nobody else can do. And I think that's what I'm really looking forward to seeing in Chengdu.
I think that's a wonderful idea. And I want to borrow your metaphor. You said melting pot, but I think you probably actually mean a hot pot, don't you? Chengdu Huoguo. That's a great idea. And I'd like to see how they bring that harmony too. Most cities do, if they want to create a creative space, they just tear everything down and start from the ground up. But here, if you go to a lot of the historic spots, they keep the trees.
Well, I think you've also got to focus on the next generation and education. And that's where my life is now. And that's why I'm here in Chengdu, to spread design education. But the city has to open its arms to that. And then it has to put some logistics behind it. You know, New York Fashion Week has been very successful because it supports young designers passionately. And I think we have the opportunity to do that here in Chengdu. And I'm prepared to do everything I can to help that to happen.
Yes, thank you, Simon.